got to say, I struggled to work out how to get the headlight out, because to change a simple thing like the sidelight bulb, instead of getting into the access to these main beam and dip beams, we would normally take out the clipped in panel at the back here, just in here, to get at those two. You can't do that to get round here. You've actually got to take the headlight right out, and then from there you can turn this little round object with the flat sides just to change that bulb. Quite a workup. So actually change the bulb itself, it's quite straightforward. Just pull it out, plug it in, and then you have to get in the back, so it goes in that way round. See that? Yeah, the flat sides there, and then turn it so that they're vertical. Now, the trouble I had was locating this screw hole down here. There was a screw right down here. Obviously, I'm going to have to put the light back into position. There's a forked piece of metal that slips around this screw, but it's easier to put the screw in afterwards. And the only clue as to where you're going, because it's very dark down there, will be this cutout here. Just here, there's a cutout, and that's where your driver will go down through there. Sort of a clue really, because there's a cutout here as well, which is the same for another screw that goes in there, but you can at least see that one. So knowing that that cutout was for that one gave me a clue then that perhaps this cutout was for this one down here. So let's see how it goes. Alright, so if you leave the light slightly out of position, you can look down through this hole where the cutout is, and you can see the fingers that you're going to try and trap with the screw. Lower the screw in a bit, get it started in the hole, and then you can push the light back into position. And then hopefully when you tighten it up, you've trapped forked retainer in place. Right, once you've tightened that one up, let's put back these two. One that's in here as well, one that's in there. I'd removed all the screws from along here as well, all along there, four of them, to give this a bit of movement. So I was able to get a bit more room down here to jiggle this around. That really did help. There's the cutout for your spanner. That's it. Let's see, used it shorter to screw that back into place. These really do feel as though you could over tighten them and strip the little thread there is on there, a bit of spring steel holding them in, forming the thread. Right, these are the little caps that were on here, sort of bonnet stops. Now, when I went to take them off, I thought they looked as though they could very easily crack. I just prised them up with a screwdriver from underneath and was a bit concerned. It's not on straight. I was a bit concerned that I was going to break them before I got them off, but just being very, very careful, they did. This is more difficult than it appears. Right, they're on, and just remains to put the four screws in here. Again, these are T25s. And I think that is it. So that's a 5 minute job, probably close to half an hour in reality. That's how I went about changing the sidelight bulb on a 2006 Galaxy. I hope someone finds it useful.